Hello, my name is Shawn Simpson. I'm the product manager for the Fortify DAST products, which includes WebInspect and ScanCentral DAST. Today I was going to show you the new API wizard. We have this is available in both WebInspect and ScanCentral DAST as well. We'll just start with WebInspect though. To access it, you can either go to File, New, you can select API Scan. We can also click on Start an API Scan from the Start page as well. Once it comes up, we have a few options. We can set a specific name, say Demo Swagger Scan. We can select various REST APIs, and with those, we can select from Swagger and OData or a Postman Collection that we can use for our scan. We can also do SOAP scans, where we can take a WSDL either from a URL or from the file system, or we could use an existing design file we may already have. For this example, we'll start with a Swagger definition. We'll run that against a copy of the pet store that I've already got set up locally. We'll select Next. Once we do that, we're actually going to parse that definition and validate it, make sure everything is up and running. We can set any network auth we may need. Here we can pick any a different policy if we wanted. By default, it uses the API policy. Choose if we want to capture the traffic, reuse false positives, add allowed hosts. Select Next. We can save that settings file, and we can start our scan. Once our scan is complete, we can come in and take a look at all the endpoints we scanned and review our findings. Next, we're going to take a look at scanning with a Postman collection. One thing to note when using a Postman collection is you do have to have Newman already installed. I've got it installed on here, but we do have it covered in our documentation exactly how you can pull that down and get it running. And an API type, we'll select Postman. We have a couple different file types we can use. A workflow, which we'll use for this one, which is going to be our collection of endpoints. Auth, which is for authentication, and then an environment file as well. In this case, I've got the pet store already set up in a collection. I'm going to hit Next, and we're going to go and validate all of those endpoints again. And with Postman, we have a little more we can do with it. So we have auth and audit. And auth are methods we need to authenticate. Audit are the ones we're actually going to send a tax to. So I'm not going to send them to the delete endpoints in this case. I'm going to uncheck all those. And I do want to note to the scanner that this user login is an authentication endpoint. So we're going to use that for getting a token. And in this case, it's an OAuth2 endpoint. I don't need to do anything else, but if I did, I could set a token strategy, either define a specific custom header token, or I could also define a response with a regex that we'd pull a token from, and a request where we would apply that token, and even additional logout condition regexes. But we don't need that in this case, so we'll set our strategy to none. Select Next. Again, we can select our policy, traffic, false positives, allowed hosts, and start our scan. Our scan is complete. And we can review all our findings, see the endpoints we've hit. Finally, we'll take a look at scanning a SOAP endpoint. For the this, we'll select configure a SOAP web service scan. We've already got the URL of the zero SOAP API's WSDL set up here, so we'll select that. Next, network authentication, same as the other ones where we can select traffic, false positives, save our settings file, and we can start a scan. With that, we have a completed SOAP scan. Thank you for taking a look at the new API wizard that we have in WebInspect. This is also, again, in ScanCentral DAST is available. If you have any questions or comments, we'd love to hear them from you in the comment section below. Thank you.